So,
kind of
yeah.
How do you feel about your game today, playing in front of your home crowd?
I don't feel good. Sorry, I actually played very hard. So, like I said, I do anything. I'm dedicated the rest of the season to my brother.
Wide open.
To Louisville. So, like I said, different risk. A lot of people saying that right now.
And do you guys feel like you got the target on your back?
Yeah, because last year they won. Making noise again this year. So, everyone try to come at us hard as they can. So, we just got to be more focused going into the tournament than we ever been.
How do you feel after playing them? Connect has got some great guards.
Yeah, they do, but we got great guards too. Yeah. But, I think three times we played against them, they struggle against us because of switching defense. So, when we keep doing that, keep running more defense during the tournament, I think we can go far.
How do you feel after playing three games in a row like that? Were you fatigued?
I wasn't fatigued. I think we got great trainers, people who take care of our bodies very well. So, I think that's why we play so hard and can play four or five games in a row without being fatigued. So that's a blessing to have trainers and coaches, staff like that around us.
Thanks a lot, Chris.
Chris got a baby chip.
Did you see the It's a Small World video last night?
No. How about Russ played the song when you got in our hotel room?
Oh, did he?
Yeah.
Oh, that's good. So you came home to Memphis and won, left here with the all tournament team. What's that mean to you?
That means a lot to me. I didn't get a lot of recognition during the tournament, on the conference because I was hurt a lot. But I just came out here to play hard as I can, play for the name on the front of my jersey. Made me all confident. That's a blessing from God and from my coaching staff, my teammates for getting me on them.
Congratulations on that. How about the little mess up with Shabazz there towards the end of the game?
I don't know what he was doing. Yeah. All I did was I tried to tell coach, I hear him. Just threw my arm out the way. Like I said, it's 2-10. Don't want to back down. Old Big East battle. So that wasn't nothing to me. I don't think he was intentional throwing it. I thought I was trying to put my arm in the face, but he's a great player.
Now, you'd made a great play, and then you kind of reacted to your teammates and seemed like he took
chance of that. But, and I tried to get Trey the hand clap, but he took it in the wrong way. But, like I said, in the heat of a battle, some things like that don't happen. Like I told him, keep in control and keep forwards under pressure. I think he was already mad from the defense when he switched up on him. So his teammates wasn't trying to help him out. So there's nothing. Like I said, two players refused to back down to one another. So things like that's gonna happen.
Winning, being on the all-tournament team in your hometown, given everything that's happened, what does that mean to you?
It's just a blessing, because coming from where I'm from,
a lot of people don't make it to my position. It's a blessing, I could have been dead, in jail right now, come from where I'm from. So just being on this stage is a blessing for me. I'm getting a lot of awards, a lot of stuff coming towards me. But I'm going to keep my head level, keep playing hard for my teammates and my brother.
What happened on that technical that you got with Shabazz and everything?
I guess he was already mad because his teammate wasn't helping him in the press with him, and then they just called foul on him. And I tried to tell one of my teammates to do the job, and he just pushed my arm out the way. But, like I said, that's two point guard, battle for trying to win a game, heat of the moment. I'm not going to back down, he's not going to back down. So things like that's going to happen between us. If we see each other again, might get a little more physical, but you never know.
Shabazz Player of the Year. You guys beat them three times. Do you think that means like anything? Do you feel like Russ maybe should have gotten it? What do you think?
I know he should have gotten it, but like I said, I don't really know. It's not my decision. It's people who in the backyard decision. I can't get it today. He won it. Congratulations. You know, we're just going to try to win a big one.
How vital is Steve?
So how hard is it to lead a team like UConn like that, as badly as you did all the time?
My thing is focus. You know, we got Coach Stella to keep us focused. You know, don't let the DS go in practice. They're helping us in the long run because, I mean, we should be an immature team. We should lose close games like that. So I guess everybody just put their head on straight, like we can't be losing games like this. So, you know, we all playing as one. You know, as we play as one, we keep rolling.
Chris, Luke just said this to us, that you guys, that every team entering the tournament has one weakness, at least one weakness. At this point, do you feel like you guys have one right now, the way you're playing?
I think our weakness is we probably get too selfish. That's about it. You know, when people go express, you know, you don't score a lot of points. You know, you get yourself. But
what seed do you think?
We play defense so hard that they try to cover up for us being selfish. We're talking about we spread the ball, then we're back on roll.
What does it mean to you to come back here? The way you guys lost here last time and to come back and get a win here in the contest?
You know, it's a blessing. Our strategy is to be on roll. I think I need this to be here with my family, my friends, seeing everyone smile. You know, even a closer friend was to him too, smile. You know, I think that brightened up my day, and it just made me get a lot of stuff off my mind. Thanks to Brett for being a great roommate with me on the road. So he just, you know, helped me through a lot of things too. So I just want to thank him and everybody who's been around me doing this trip.
Now, for you.